to start with network layer of OSI model. Fine. So yesterday we have discussed about OSI model. How many layers were there?
Seven.
Application, presentation, session, transport, network, physical. Guys, there is a term called PDU. What is the term? Protocol Data Unit. PDU is the form of request at particular layer. See, my computer is sending a request to the server or to any other computer or to any other device in the network. Agree? So what I am saying, when my computer has to send a request, it has to go through all of these layers. Yes, it has to go through all of these layers. And what is PDU? Form of request at particular layer. Meri request ki kya form hogi ek particular layer pe, wo kya hoga? PDU. PDU stands for Protocol Data Unit. Clear? See, my computer is communicating with the server. Okay, how many of you know about FTP server? Okay, in your colleges, fine. I think there was a FTP server. Fine. People usually access this server to download just think like I have to download a book of C++. What I will do? I will send a request to the server. Now what I am saying, when I will send a request, my computer has to build a block of information. That block will contain information of layer 7 also, layer 6 also, layer 5 also, layer 4 also, 3, 2, 1. At last, this information will be sent on this media in the form of signals. Agree? Now the server will receive this particular information. Fine. And he will get to know what is present in the request. Mere server ko at the end pata chal jayega ke request ke andar aaya kya hai. Now what is PDU? PDU means request, form of data at every layer. What is the form of request you are sending? What is it? What we call it at every layer? At this layer it is called data. At layer 6 it is called data. At layer 5 it is also called data. But at layer 4, what we are doing is I am dividing my data according to the defined MSS. This thing is clear. Now layer 4 will check first thing, the request coming from layer 7 is using which protocol. Let's say it is using HTTP. So layer 4 will get to know I have to add a TCP header with this data. Agree? Yes. Now this particular thing will become segment. and a sequence number is provided to this segment. An issue? Sequence number is provided to every segment. Yesterday we discussed the concept of sequencing, if you remember. Fine. What was sequencing? What's the benefit of sequencing? What is saying? Like, you are downloading something through IDM. Fine. In the middle, your internet got stuck. Fine. When you connect again, you can download from the same point. You don't have to download it again. Fine. Any issues? Now, there, I was expecting a question from your side. Sir, what about port numbers? We are on transport layer, but you haven't discussed anything about port numbers, where they are used. See, what I am saying, now your computer will check at layer 4 that the application you are using at layer 7 will use TCP or UDP. Our application was HTTP, that's why we use here. See now, whether it is TCP or it is UDP, both headers contain field called port numbers. It means port numbers are binded in which header? TCP and UDP headers. This thing is fine. Clear to all of you? Yesterday we discussed about SYNBIT, if you remember. After that we discussed about now. See, what thing I am telling you now? Try to understand it. Now I am on which layer? Transport layer. Till now, my request is in the computer. Fine. It will leave the computer or it is sended on the wire at physical layer. Fine. This thing is clear. So what I am trying to tell you, whenever computer has to establish a TCP connection, fine, your actual data or your actual request will be on hold. Will be on hold. First, computer will send information up to layer 4. Information up to layer 4. To whom? To the server. It will not use for the first time all 7 layers, because first of all it has to build a TCP connection with the server. So what it will do, it will send first of all request with SYNBIT on. With SYNBIT on. Where you will find this SYNBIT? In TCP header. This thing is fine. Now server will reply with ACK plus SYN, and you will reply with ACK. Now your computer will send data with how many layer information? Layer 7. It means now your actual HTTP traffic will flow. This thing is clear. But before that, only information up to layer 4 will flow. This thing is clear? Up to this point, any issue?
Just for request, it send the data for pin 4 layer.
Aap apni query Hindi mein bhi pooch sakte ho, koi issue nahi hai. Feel free to ask things.
Matlab jab request bheja hota hai system,
जब कनेक्शन बना रहा होता है तब, व्हेन द कंप्यूटर इज ट्राइंग टू एस्टेब्लिश अ कनेक्शन फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम इट विल सेंड इंफॉर्मेशन अप टू लेयर फोर. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इट विल एस्टेब्लिश अ कनेक्शन, देन इट विल सेंड इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट ऑल द लेयर्स. दिस थिंग इज क्लियर. नाउ नेक्स्ट लेयर, नाउ कंप्यूटर विल हैंड ओवर डेटा टू लेयर थ्री. व्हाट इज द वर्क ऑफ लेयर थ्री? द वर्क ऑफ नेटवर्क लेयर इज टू प्रोवाइड लॉजिकल एड्रेसिंग. द पीपल हु आर सेइंग दैट लेयर थ्री विल प्रोवाइड देम राउटिंग इज रॉन्ग. Routing is the function of the device which is used in transit. Routing is never the function of layer 3. Layer 3. Listen to me carefully. At layer 3, we use a device called router. This is actually the work of router, routing and path selection. You will not count it again as the function of layer 3. What is the function of layer 3? To provide logical addressing. That's all. Fine. Function of layer 3 to provide C. At layer 4 I was having a PC for UDP. I call this thing as fine. Now at layer 3 some more information is added to this segment. What is that information? Information is actually IP header. In IP header, what is the information? Basically source IP and this information is also binded with this segment and it will become now packet. This thing is clear. Any issues? Now at layer 2, the work of layer 2 is to provide physical addressing. How it will provide physical addressing? By adding source MAC address and destination MAC address to this packet. Here I have a packet. With this packet, computer will add source MAC and destination MAC. And at the end, it will add FCS. This is called data link header. This is called data link trailer. Trailer means the things which are added at the end. Header means the things which are added in the an issue. This whole thing will become now frame. यार देखो मैंने Just I speak this word FCS. I will tell the meaning, yeah. Give me some time. FCS stands for frame, check, sequence. Actually, FCS is a hash value. Why we use it? We use it for error detection. How? You will get to know. Wait for 5 minutes. Fine? Any issues till now? So, at layer 4, which headers were added? TCP and UDP. At layer 3, which headers were added? In IP header, information was? Very good. At layer 2, information was added? Data link header. Data link trailer. In data link header, information was of source MAC and FCS means frame check sequence. This thing is clear. Now we will move on to which layer? Layer? Layer 1. That is our physical layer. Now, this whole information will be converted into bits and will be transferred on the link. The work of physical layer is to analyze physical media. See, if this physical media will not work properly, there is no use of having perfect information of all the layers. What I am trying to say, if this physical media is not working fine, so you have information about all 7 layers. It will not matter, man, because you are not able to send the data because your physical layer is not working fine. So what is the actual work of physical layer? To check that this particular link is up or down. Who will check this thing? Physical layer. That this particular link is up or down. How? How? See, just try to understand what it will do. It will send some packets after every specific. Don't think packet as layer 3 packets now. Fine. It will send some signals after every specific amount of time just to check that connectivity is up or not. This thing is clear? So what is the work of physical layer? To check your physical media. Physical media is working fine or not. You can say that. Yes, both. At layer 2, I have IP also. I have TCP, UDP also. I have layer 2 header also. The header, I named it like data link header. That header is actually layer 2 header. Fine? Yaar, ping karte hai to layer 3 tak use hota. Par sir, abhi aap ping ke baare mein mat socho. Fine? मैं लेके आऊंगा आपको पिंग तक खुद.
बिट्स ट्रांसफर होते हैं फ्रेम के, बिट्स ट्रांसफर होते हैं या पैकेट के.
ओके, नाउ आई विल टेल यू द ट्रुथ. इंफॉर्मेशन विल ऑलवेज रिमेन इन द फॉर्म ऑफ बिट्स. यस, कंप्यूटर विल अंडरस्टैंड इंफॉर्मेशन इन द फॉर्म ऑफ वेदर इट इज लेयर 7 और इट इज लेयर 1. कंप्यूटर अंडरस्टैंड इट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ बिट्स. सो व्हाट कंप्यूटर इज डूइंग एट लेयर 7, कंप्यूटर विल बिल्ड सम इंफॉर्मेशन इन फॉर्म ऑफ बिट्स. At layer 6, it will remain bits. At layer 4, some extra bits are added. At layer 3, some more extra bits are added. At layer 2, some more extra bits are added. Now at layer 1, these bits will transfer. This is what going on. Fine? Now, yes. क्वेश्चन रिपीट कर यार. ये यूजर है दिस इज कंप्यूटर दिस इज सर्वर. नाउ यू आर ओपनिंग योर फेसबुक अकाउंट. व्हाट आई टोल्ड यू फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल ही विल डायरेक्ट ही विल नॉट सेंड HTTP request. He will send a SYN bit on request. It means first of all when he will send the information, information will be up to layer 4. First of all a connection is established. Now he will send information about all the layers. It means layer 7 also. Now what is your question?
है
यार फिजिकल मीडिया की कनेक्टिविटी होना अलग बात है. आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट एक यहाँ एक एंड टू एंड कनेक्शन एट लेयर 4 देयर विल बी अ एंड टू एंड कनेक्शन. This is the network. You are sitting here. This is your broadband connection, or you can say this is your router. You are sitting at your home. This router will be connected to ISP, will be connected to Facebook. So that physical connectivity will be checked between these two things. Fine. And that connection of layer 4 will be between you and your server. Never think it like this, yaar. Your computer cannot send signal to the server. It's not possible. You will check your own physical media, not all the physical media. See, after this router, responsibility is of ISP to check its physical media. It is not my responsibility. My computer will check only up to my router. My physical media is up or not. Fine. And the TCP connection that is built, it is between my computer and
server.
Facebook server. This was the concept I was trying to explain. Fine. Okay. Now we will discuss the main thing that is called flow. सर्वर को बिल्कुल एक मिनट ओ भाई रुक जाओ एक मिनट प्लीज यार. फिजिकल मीडिया पे ही तो वो डेटा कंप्यूटर से बाहर निकलेगा. अभी गया थोड़ा ना है
डेटा की बात नहीं कर रहा मैं. आपने सिंक पैकेट भेजा.
ओ भाई सिंक पैकेट को ही डेटा बोल ले तू.
अरे सर सिंक अपन ने कनेक्शन बनाया
बनाया अरे भाई देख, तू पता क्या सोच रहा है, ट्रांसपोर्ट लेयर पे कनेक्शन बन गया है। मैं पता है इतनी देर से क्या भौंकने की कोशिश कर रहा हूं कि भाई फिजिकल लेयर पे चीज बाहर निकलेगी, कैसे कनेक्शन बन गया ट्रांसपोर्ट लेयर पे? भाई एक बात बता, फिजिकल लेयर पे इंफॉर्मेशन सिग्नल में कन्वर्ट होगी, लिंक पे ट्रेवल करेगी, एग्री और नॉट? भाई ट्रांसपोर्ट लेयर पे कौन सा कनेक्शन बन गया था पहले? अभी तो सिंह जाएगी बाहर। आप ऐसा क्यों सोच रहे हो भाई? तो मैं उसको समझा रहा था, वो भी बंदा ऐसे सोच रहा है कि ट्रांसपोर्ट लेयर पे बंद हो गया कनेक्शन। ट्रांसपोर्ट लेयर पे कैसे बन गया कनेक्शन? भाई देखो यही फ्लो समझा रहा था कि भाई यहां से आप चलोगे, ये होगा डेटा, यहां भी क्या होगा डेटा, एट दिस लेयर इट विल बी, एट दिस लेयर इट विल बी डेटा प्लस टीसीपी और यूडीपी, एट दिस लेयर इट विल बी डेटा टीसीपी और आईपी, एट दिस लेयर इट विल बी डेटा टीसीपी आईपी डेटा लिंक हेडर एंड एट द एंड इट विल बी डेटा लिंक, एट दिस लेयर इंफॉर्मेशन विल बी सेंड ऑन द फिजिकल मीडिया। नाउ कहां बना कोई कनेक्शन? वेयर इज द कनेक्शन? नाउ कंप्यूटर विल सेंड दिस इंफॉर्मेशन फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम, नाउ इन दिस टीसीपी हेडर सिनबिट विल बी ऑन, फाइन फाइन भाई। ट्रांसपोर्ट लेयर पे पहले ही कोई कनेक्शन नहीं बन जाता, अब ये इंफॉर्मेशन गई किसके पास? नाउ दिस इंफॉर्मेशन विल रीच टू द सर्वर। नाउ व्हाट सर्वर विल डू? फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल सर्वर विल चेक विच लेयर? सर्वर विल चेक डेटा लिंक लेयर। व्हाट इंफॉर्मेशन इट विल चेक? डेटा लिंक हेडर। इट मींस फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल सर्वर विल चेक विच थिंग? फ्रेम। इन फ्रेम व्हाट सर्वर विल चेक? फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल डेटा लिंक हेडर टू चेक दैट डेस्टिनेशन मैक इज ऑफ द सर्वर और नॉट। इफ डेस्टिनेशन मैक इज नॉट ऑफ सर्वर, सर्वर विल ड्रॉप दिस फ्रेम। नाउ डेस्टिनेशन मैक इज ऑफ सर्वर, नाउ सर्वर विल चेक डेटा लिंक ट्रेलर। नाउ व्हाट इज दिस डेटा लिंक ट्रेलर? डेटा लिंक ट्रेलर इज यूज्ड फॉर एरर डिटेक्शन। प्लीज डू नॉट कंफ्यूज योर सेल्फ बिटवीन डिटेक्शन एंड करेक्शन, आई एम स्ट्रिक्टली सेइंग इट एज डिटेक्शन। व्हाट सर्वर विल डू? सर्वर विल रन अ एल्गोरिथम ऑन द फ्रेम। सर्वर विल रन अ एल्गोरिथम ऑन द फ्रेम। इट विल कैलकुलेट अ हैश। नाउ इट विल मैच दैट हैश विद द हैश गिवन इन दिस एफसीएस फील्ड। इफ बोथ ऑफ द हैशेस विल मैच ओनली देन सर्वर विल एक्सेप्ट द इंफॉर्मेशन, अदरवाइज सर्वर विल नेवर एक्सेप्ट द इंफॉर्मेशन। नाउ वट आई थिंक एट लेयर टू माई डेस्टिनेशन मैक एड्रेस इज ऑल्सो चेक्ड, इट इज मैच्ड एंड एफ सी एस इज ऑल्सो चेक्ड। नाउ कंप्यूटर विल रिमूव डेटा लिंक हेडर एंड डेटा लिंक ट्रेलर एंड इट विल गिव द इंफॉर्मेशन टू लेयर थ्री, दैट इज माई नेटवर्क लेयर। नाउ कंप्यूटर विल चेक डेस्टिनेशन आई पी एड्रेस इज ऑफ सर्वर और नॉट। If destination IP addresses of server, it will remove the layer 3 header and it will give information to layer 4. Now at layer 4, server will check destination port number. Destination port number is 80. Now in TCP header, server will check, yeah, here is a SYN bit on. It means this computer is trying to establish a TCP connection with me. It means this time I don't have to check information of layer 7. First of all, I have to establish a TCP connection. Now server will reply. Server will reply with which bits on? SYN and ACK. It will reach up to computer. Now computer will reply with ACK bit. Now computer will send its actual data, actual HTTP request. This thing is clear? So this will be the flow. When I will send some information, that particular thing is called encapsulation, because I am adding some headers. When I will receive the information, it will be decapsulation, because I am removing some headers. Fine. इंफॉर्मेशन कंप्यूटर से बाहर कौन सी लेयर पे निकलेगी? फिजिकल लेयर पे. ट्रांसपोर्ट लेयर पे सिर्फ एक इंफॉर्मेशन सेट होगी. आई विल जस्ट सेट अ इंफॉर्मेशन ऑन द ट्रांसपोर्ट लेयर. एट ट्रांसपोर्ट लेयर इंफॉर्मेशन कैन नॉट गो आउट ऑफ योर कंप्यूटर. सो दिस विल बी द फ्लो. दिस थिंग इज क्लियर? पूछो. यस. दोनों तरह से बना सकते हो. एक्चुअली फायरवॉल क्या करता, मेरे सीक्वेंस नंबर को चेंज कर देता. तो नाउ व्हाट आई कैन डू, आई कैन डू टू थिंग्स. या तो मैं फायरवॉल को बोल दूं कि मेरे सीक्वेंस नंबर को चेंज नहीं करना, या फिर वो सिक्योरिटी नंबर को चेंज करके भेजेगा. जो प्रॉब्लम आएगी वो आपको फेस करनी पड़ेगी. दोनों काम कर सकता है वो. ये क्वेश्चन बेसिकली कैसे पूछा जाता है, लाइक आई हैव टू बिल्ड नेबरशिप बिटवीन टू राउटर्स, बीजीपी नेबरशिप. सो आई हैव अ फायरवॉल इन बिटवीन. हाउ इट विल वर्क, लाइक यू नो अबाउट बीजीपी, सो यू कैन रिलेट दीज थिंग्स. हाँ यार एक बात और, अगर किसी को आता है, फाइन, इफ यू नो something that some of you don't know, you can ask your question. It's not like you cannot ask your question. जैसे इन्होंने पूछा, he know about firewall, he can ask a question related to firewall. But I will not explain the same thing to all of you because you are not on the same track. Fine. देखो जी, ये नॉर्मली व्हाट आई एम डूइंग इज आई एम कैप्चरिंग माय वैन गार्ड, आई हैव अ डब्ल्यू लैन गार्ड, वायरलेस लैन. हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू नो अबाउट वायरलेस लैन? वाई फाई, आई हैव अ वाई फाई अडेप्टर इन माई लैपटॉप, आई एम कैप्चरिंग इट, आई एम कनेक्टेड टू इंटरनेट. वट आई वॉज ट्राइंग टू टेल यू, दिस इज द TCP प्रोटोकॉल. माई कंप्यूटर इज ट्राइंग टू एस्टेब्लिश अ कनेक्शन विद दिस IP 173.194.120. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इट विल सेंड ओनली इंफॉर्मेशन अप टू लेयर 4. एनी प्रॉब्लम? आफ्टर दैट इट विल सेंड इंफॉर्मेशन अप टू अगेन अप टू लेयर 4. यू कैन सी हियर लेयर 4, लेयर 4, लेयर 4, लेयर 4. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इट विल एस्टेब्लिश अ कनेक्शन, देन इट विल सेंड एक्चुअल डेटा. यू कैन सी हियर SSL. What is SSL? Secure Sockets Layer. Now the people who know the difference between HTTP and HTTPS can understand this thing. The one who don't know have to read about it. What is the difference between HTTP and HTTPS? I will show you actual data also. This is your actual data. This is your request. This is the form of data. You can say, see here. This is the form of data. Binary. Leave. Ek cheez aur. This is your TCP header. Information in TCP header. First information. Second. After that. How many flags are there? See, SYN flag. ACK flag. We have urgent also. We have push also. We have reset also. We have CWR also. We have ECN. ECO also. Which flag is set by default? Fine. Windowing. Who was asking about windowing? This is called your window size. Fine. Checksum. We will discuss about TCP header. After that, we have which header? Layer 3 header. After layer 4, we have layer 3 header. In layer 3 header, information is of source IP and destination IP, and we have many more information. We will discuss it when we will discuss about headers. After that, we have which header? Layer 2 header. Destination MAC address, source MAC address. We have the thing. Any issues? No. So till now, one thing is clear, that if I am sending a request, I have to move from layer 7 to layer 1, and if I am receiving a request, I have to move from layer 7. So when I'm sending it, flow will be like this. When I'm receiving it, flow will be like this. Any issues? Now guys. यही तो सबसे पहली बात बताई. All request is not of application layer. Why? If you are using TCP, first of all, a TCP connection is established. उसके बाद रिक्वेस्ट कौन सी लेयर से जाएगी? लेयर 7 से. गाइस जस्ट टेल मी वन थिंग, व्हेन यू प्रेस रीसेट बटन, सॉरी रीलोड बटन ऑन योर ब्राउजर, व्हाट योर ब्राउजर विल डू? I just show you a reset flag in the TCP header. It will set that reset flag and send it to the server, telling the server that I want to reset this connection. My connection is not working. When you press close button of your browser, what your computer will do? Your computer will set a fin flag present in the TCP header and send it to the server. Just to tell the server, connection is closed. Please remove my entry from your cache. This thing is clear? Otherwise, anyone can attack the server. If connection is not closed, anyone can attack a server. Ek dukaan hai. There is a shop. You are going there to purchase rice. One people is going 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It's not possible, yaar. A shopkeeper cannot sell the same rice to thousands of people. It's not possible. And there is a chance that those thousands of people can attack the shopkeeper. Yes. So how the things are going on? He will give rice to one guy and he will say, go back. He will give rise to second guy and he will say, go back. When you will finish a connection, you have to tell the server that I am ending up the connection. This is how things will work. Yes. हाँ जी होता है. हिस्ट्री क्लियर कर देना एक बार. कर दियो हिस्ट्री क्लियर. यार तुम यार एक बात बताओ यार, मैंने अपना फेसबुक चलाया हुआ है, अपना इंटरनेट बंद पड़ा है, फेसबुक तो फिर भी आएगा यार. आई विल गेट फेसबुक देन ऑल्सो इफ माई इंटरनेट इज नॉट वर्किंग. सो व्हाट इज द कनेक्शन बिटवीन फेसबुक एंड इंटरनेट? वो तो चीज लोड हुई पड़ी है मेरे सिस्टम पे. सर आप अपना पेज दोबारा लोड करते हो, लोड होता है, वो घूमता है, तभी तो इन्फॉर्मेशन अपडेट होती है. इंटरनेट ही नहीं होगा, इन्फॉर्मेशन अपडेट कैसे होगी? आपने अपना ब्राउजर खोला, पहले हिस्ट्री में पासवर्ड सेव पड़ा था, आपने वो सेम पेज खोला, कंप्यूटर ने रिक्वेस्ट भेजी फेसबुक सर्वर को कि हाँ भाई मुझे मेरी अपडेटेड इन्फॉर्मेशन दो. फिर से होगा? यस, दैट्स व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू टेल यू. When you will reset the connection, connection will be actually reset. Computer will again make the connection with the server. और बताओ. हर एक क्लिक पे एक नया कनेक्शन बनेगा. Now guys. First of all, we will discuss about how these two guys will communicate if I connect them through a wire. Till now, we know one thing. We know flow of data. All of us know that if two devices want to communicate, which model they have to use? Okay, one more thing. Nowadays, OSI model is not actually used. We people are using TCP/IP model. So there is no difference between OSI and TCP/IP. Just difference is of number of layers. In TCP/IP, number of layers are 4. In OSI, number of layers are 7. This is the only difference. You can read the difference in your books. If you will find any, just tell me also. Fine. Next thing. So, how these two guys will communicate. We already discussed about IP address and MAC address. We are clear with these two terms, all of you? Fine. So what I am saying now, that this guy is having IP of 10.0.0.1. I am connecting them with the same wire. So this device must exist in the same network or in the different network? In the same network. So I am assigning this guy IP of 10.0.0.20. 10.0.0.20 and 10.0.0.1 will be in same network or different network?
Same network.
Are you all fool? You have to ask me, sir, define subnet mask first. Then only we can tell these both IPs belong to same network or different network. It will just take 1 minute to prove you people wrong. How? Now they are. So you have to ask, sir, what is the subnet mask? Because on the basis of subnet mask, we people decide, or computer will decide, to which network this particular IP belongs to. Aapka pehla din aaj. This thing is clear. If we don't have subnet mask, our computer cannot decide to which network our computer belongs to. Fine. So first condition is subnet mask. So I am defining here subnet mask as /8. Now both of them belong to same. If I define it /24, now also both of them belong to same network. Fine. Guys, first thing. If these two guys have to communicate, up to which layer they have to exchange the information? Up to which layer they have to exchange information? All 7 layers were used, will be used. Just tell me. All 7 layers will be used, yes or no?
Yes.
See, it is like this. It depends on the service I am using between these two guys. See, how these two guys can communicate. First way. Just tell me the possibilities. How these two guys can communicate. I have connected two computers through a wire. Fine, IP address of this is 10.0.0.1. 10.0.0/. Its MAC address is A. Its MAC address is B. How many ways are there? In how many ways they can communicate? First is, I can ping. Ping means, packet fine, packet internet. It is a utility. It will use which protocol? ICMP works at which layer? Layer 3. Always keep one thing in mind. If you are telling me about some protocol, you must know this thing, that at which layer it works. And if that protocol works at layer 4 or above, you must know the port numbers. These are the two requirements. Fine. Now, ICMP works at layer 3. It means if I ping from this computer to this computer, how many layers will be used? 3. Because I am using a protocol which is ICMP, which works at which layer? Layer 3. Now, if I treat this computer as a server and I install a FTP application on this computer, how many of you know how to configure your computer as a FTP server? You can do this thing. Yes, you can configure your computer as a FTP server. Now people can download files from your computer. Okay, on the first day you told me to share some files through your network. Fine. What was that thing? That was not FTP. That is just a example similar to FTP. That I have shared some files, you are connected to my computer through a network, you can download those files. This thing is clear. Any issues? It means if someone is using FTP, FTP is a protocol which works at layer 7. At this time, how many layers will be used? 7 layers. So what I am trying to tell you, it depends on the user, what service he is using. So on the basis of that service, computer will build the information and computer will use the layers accordingly. If you are pinging, computer will use how many layers? 3. If you are using FTP, computer will build how many layers?
7.
This thing is clear. Fine. So now I am starting with a very basic thing. Ping. How ping works? Fine. This thing is clear. Fine. Any issue? Now, this computer is having MAC address of A. IP. This computer is having MAC address IP. Fine. Now guys, always keep one thing in mind, that if this guy want to communicate with this guy need 4 things. How many things? What are those 4 things? Destination MAC. See, who will tell him the source IP? He will copy it from its NIC. What IP address you have assigned? Source IP will be from where the computer will get the source IP? From the
NIC.
Who will assign the IP address on the NIC? We agree. Who will tell him about the destination IP? We. Destination IP will be. Who will tell him about the source MAC? Again the NIC. Source MAC address of the computer is burnt on the NIC. So let's say MAC address is A. Now, try to understand a simple logic. I am saying, if computer has to communicate with another computer, or a device has to communicate with another device, I am saying device A must know about MAC address of device B. I am saying this thing. Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes. It means device A must store this MAC address in its memory. Yes or no? If I ask you, you know about Sunny Leon? Yes. How he is able to answer me? Because Sunny Leon is in his memory. Not in that pause. Fine. You are in the class right now. Fine. So what I am... Okay. If I ask you, you know about pyramids? Yeah. Pyramids are in Egypt. How we know this thing? Because this thing is in my memory. The same thing I am telling you. That I am saying that 10001 knows about MAC address of 10020 or don't know about MAC address of 10020. There are 2 cases. If he knows, then he has to store this information in the memory. And if he don't know, we will see to it what will happen. Fine. So now that memory is called ARP cache. ARP cache is by default empty. It means 10001 does not know about MAC address of 10020. If he knows about, there will be entry. That 10.0.0.20 is having a MAC address of B. And he can put here B and he can send the
data.
Sorry. This thing is clear, but now 10.0.0.1 does not know about MAC address of 10.0.0.20. What 10.0.0.1 will do? See, when I know about destination IP address, but I don't know about destination MAC address. Guys sitting in the last, when I know about destination IP address, but I don't know about destination MAC address, my computer will generate a packet. My computer will generate a packet. That packet is called R packet. R stands for address resolution protocol. See, I'm resoluting something. I am finding destination MAC address with the help of destination IP address. R stands for address resolution fine. What is the use of ARP? When I know about destination IP address, but I don't know about, my computer will generate a ARP packet. What is the use of ARP? ARP is used to resolve MAC address from IP address. This thing is clear. Now, how many computers are connected on the segment? Two. Who know this thing? We? Computer? Don't know. Agree? Computer have eyes like us. We have eyes. So we can determine that how many computers are there? Two. What computer will think? That there can be one computer also and there can be many computer also. And computer don't know about destination MAC address. Agree or not? So what computer will do? Computer will broadcast this particular packet. Computer will always broadcast the ARP packet. This thing is clear? How? Fine. Now see, what computer will do? ARP request. In ARP request, there will be a एन इश्यू पता नहीं है ना तो भेजना तो पड़ेगा कुछ ना कुछ लगा के. एग्री और नॉट? सोर्स आईपी. व्हाट विल बी द सोर्स आईपी? डेस्टिनेशन आईपी. सोर्स मैक. डेस्टिनेशन मैक. ऑल एफ. कंप्यूटर विल सेंड दिस broadcast to the on the link. Now if multiple devices are connected on this link, all of them will get this broadcast. Agree or not? Agree or not? Fine. Now all of the guys will get the broadcast. Who will reply to this broadcast? The one who is having a destination IP of 10.0.0.20. Now he will send a ARP reply. In ARP reply, source IP will be 20. Destination IP will be? Source MAC will be? Destination MAC will be? All of you are clear up to this point? Now this guy will send this packet back to the source. But before sending the packet, he will make an entry in its ARP table that 10001 is having MAC address of A. Any issue? This thing is clear? Now he will send the ARP reply back to the computer and computer will make an entry that 10020 is having a MAC address of B and he is having an entry 10001 is having a MAC address of A. Now he will send actual ping. He will send actual ping. Now ping uses which protocol? ICMP. Layer 3 protocol. Today we will just discuss one more thing. What is that thing? All of you understand ARP? How ARP will work? Till now I have not introduced any devices. I have not discussed anything about switch, router or anything. Till now we have discussed only about ARP and how two devices which are directly connected to each other, how they will communicate. Fine. Today the main topic for discussion is how you will recognize the protocol is layer 3 or the protocol is layer 2 or the protocol is layer 7 or the protocol is layer 4. How you will recognize this thing. Fine. So I will start from layer 7. I call a protocol C. This is my way of thinking. This can be right, this can be wrong. Fine. You have to read this thing in your book. What I think that if any protocol uses TCP or UDP, any protocol which uses TCP or UDP, it works at which layer? Layer 7. First thing. Fine. If any protocol uses IP header, it works at layer 3. If any protocol uses layer 2 header, it works at layer 2. This thing is clear? Fine. Any issue? ARP works at which layer? C. Okay. Wait for some time. Just wait. Now, again my question is, see guys, we people are using ARP from the time when there was no OSI or no TCP IP model. See, communication was going on before TCP IP model, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Fine. Communication was going on. It means we were using ARP before OSI model also. How you can fit a protocol in OSI model if it was invented before OSI model? So this is a debatable topic. If you ask someone at which layer ARP works, he will say at layer 2 or someone will say at layer 3. See, I think it works at layer 2.5. Why? When computer will generate a ARP, it will add layer 2 header with the ARP packet, but it will never add IP header. So it never works at layer 3. It works at layer 2.5. Now you will say, why you are saying 2.5? Because in the ARP packet we have information about IP address. That's why I am saying it works at layer 2.5. but ARP packet or ARP information never include layer 3 header. It always include which header?
Layer
2. It means whenever computer will generate ARP, how many headers will be there? 2. One is layer 2 header and other is ARP header. Other is ARP header. Now whenever you will ping, ping will use which protocol?
ICMP.
How many headers will be there? Layer 2 header. ICMP is which layer protocol?
Layer
3. Layer 3 protocol means it will use which header? IP header. IP header and third header will be of ICMP. There will be total 3 headers. One is of layer 2, other is of why ARP? Bhai, kitne log confuse hai ARP aur ping mein? Tell me the truth. देखो व्हाट आई एम सेइंग, दो केस है यार. आई एम डिस्कसिंग हियर टू केसेस. फर्स्ट, व्हेन योर कंप्यूटर विल जनरेट ARP, हाउ मेनी हेडर्स विल बी देयर? वन इज लेयर टू हेडर एंड अदर इज ARP हेडर. यही तो मैंने बोला यार, ARP जब भी आप यूज करोगे लेयर 3 हेडर नहीं होगा. अगर लेयर 3 हेडर होता तो ARP किस लेयर का प्रोटोकॉल हो जाता? इफ देयर विल बी अ लेयर 3 हेडर, ARP वर्क्स. ARP will work at which layer? Layer 3. But there is no layer 3 header. So that's why I say ARP works at layer. Second is, I am talking about ping. Ping uses which protocol? How many headers will be there? Layer 2? Layer 3? Then which header? ICMP. ICMP also exists at which layer? 3. Fine. ICMP का भी लगेगा. तो यार आप पिंग किस लेयर पे यूज कर रहे हो? लेयर 3 पे. आपको आइडेंटिफाई क्या करना पड़ेगा? आईपी. ARP जनरेट होगी ही होगी. वो बैकएंड पे ARP जनरेट होगी. ARP कैसे बनेगा वो बात भी अभी करेंगे. फाइन, दिस थिंग इज क्लियर. एक मिनट यार, if I am sending a HTTP request, how many headers will be there? Layer 2? Layer 3? Layer 4. Any more headers? No. We don't care. We never care about which header. HTTP, that is not our concern. So if we are sending information of layer 7, how many headers will be there? 3. Layer 2? Layer 3? Layer 4. This thing is clear. You have to opt L2 for example sector. Next concern, this is a guy, this is a guy. Fine, they have to exchange some data. Before exchanging data, what is the requirement? They had a physical connection, but before exchanging data, requirement is they must know about MAC address of each other. Only then they can exchange data. If they don't know about MAC address of each other, what they will do? They will generate ARP. ARP stands for Address Resolution Protocol. मैं कहां से ARP जनरेट करूंगा भाई? कंप्यूटर ही करेगा. ना हुआ फिर यार, वो ICMP बिहेवियर होता है. दैट इज ICMP बिहेवियर. ICMP क्या कहता है? ICMP कहता है मैंने एक ICMP रिक्वेस्ट भेजी, अगर मुझे रिप्लाई 2 सेकंड में नहीं मिला तो मैं पैकेट को क्या कर दूंगा? ड्रॉप. और दोबारा अपना नया पैकेट भेज दूंगा. फाइन, दैट इज द बिहेवियर ऑफ आईसीएमपी, नॉट जैसा आप सोच रहे हो. तो पहली बार आर्थ रिजॉल्व हो रही होती है ना बैक एंड में, तभी होता है. ऑल ऑफ यू आर अवेयर ऑफ दिस सॉफ्टवेयर? नहीं तो आज आप लैब में जाके सर से पूछना, सर पैकेट ट्रेसर के बारे में बताओ. फाइन, आई टुक टू कंप्यूटर्स, आई कनेक्टेड देम विद अ केबल. एनी इश्यू? आई असाइन इट आईपी ऑफ 10.0.0.1/24 एंड दिस गाय विद आईपी ऑफ. फाइन, एनी इश्यूज? नो. क्लिक ऑन द कंप्यूटर, गो टू फाइन. वट इज डिफॉल्ट गेट वे? वी डोंट नो अबाउट इट टिल नाउ. वी नो अबाउट आईपी, वी नो अबाउट सबनेट मास्क. फाइन, दिस गाय हैज टू कम्युनिकेट विद 10.0.0.20. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई विल चेक आर टेबल ऑफ दिस गाय. डू दिस गाय नोज अबाउट ऑफ मैक एड्रेस ऑफ 10.0.0.20 और हाउ आई विल चेक? एआरपी माइनस ए. व्हाट ही इज सेइंग, इट मींस व्हेन एवर इट हैज टू कम्युनिकेट विद 10.0.0.20 इट विल जनरेट आर. एग्री? एनी प्रॉब्लम? नो. सेम थिंग विद दिस गाय ऑल्सो. नो एंट्रीज. फाइन, सी नाउ व्हाट आई विल डू, पिंग 10.0.0 व्हाट इज सेइंग. What is the size of ping packet when it is generated by computer? 32 bytes. This thing is clear? Now, see, this is your actually ping packet. This is your actual, but computer will not send it directly because computer does not know about MAC address. First of all, he will send which packet? ARP packet. Which packet? You want to open it? See here. Out layer means computer is sending this information out. In layer means computer is receiving this particular information. This thing is clear? Now he is sending the R packet. Source IP is? Destination IP is? Source MAC is? Who is having this MAC address? I will click on the computer. I will go to config. I will go to fast ethernet and I will read here. This is the MAC address of computer. Any issues? Now, computer will send this packet out to other computer. Other computer will receive this information. It means we will find the same information in layers. You can check here. In layers. Source IP is, destination IP is, source MAC is this, destination MAC. Out layer means computer 2 will reply. Source IP is, destination IP is, source MAC is of computer 2 and destination MAC is of computer 1. But side by side computer 2 has maintained a entry in its ARP table. We can check how. It is having an entry that 10001 is having a MAC address 00014367EB8A. Fine. Now it will send this reply back to the sender. Sender will receive the reply. Now sender must be having a entry. We cannot check this entry now. Fine, we can check, we will check this entry in the end. Fine. Now ARP is resolved. Now he will send the actual ICMP packet. Now when he is sending actual ICMP packet, wait. Fine. You can see here, it is sending the packet. How many layer information is there? Layer 3 header, layer 2 header. And you can read this thing, ICMP message type. How many headers will be there? Layer 2, layer 3, and third will be ICMP. You want to check? You can check here. Layer 2 header, source MAC, destination MAC. Layer 3 header, source IP. After that, which header? ICMP. This thing is clear? Now, computer is sending a ping 10001, 10020. When he is replying, sources, destination is, this thing is clear? He will send back the reply to sender. See, what information you are getting? Reply from, size of reply, time 4 millisecond. What is TTL? We will discuss tomorrow. What is TTL? Like this, how many packets it will send? How many packets it will send? 4. It means two things are clear now. That whenever any computer has to communicate or any device has to communicate with another device, he must know about MAC address of that device. If he don't know, he cannot communicate. First thing. Second thing. If I am pinging from one computer to another computer, what will be the size of ping?
32
bytes. How many packets will
Four.
It
Four.
Will send?
Four.
Four. This thing is clear. Last example. I will take a server. Fine. IP. Fine. This server is having an application called HTTP, which is by default running on this server. You can say a web page is saved on this server. I can access this web page from my computer by using its browser. How? I will click on the computer, I will go to, I will write the IP address of server. 10.0.0.20. But I will write, I'm getting the page, I'm getting the web page. Fine. Any issues? No. So I have this web page. See, for the first time when computer will establish a connection, 10.0.0, which packet is this? Which packet is this? Open this. Up to which layer information you are having? 4. Up to which layer? four. Fine. Which bit is on? Sin. Sequence number is? Acknowledgement number is? Zero. Fine. Source port, destination port. Source IP, destination IP, and layer 2 header. Fine. First of all, it will send this packet out. Now server will reply. See now. Server will reply with sin plus ack. Fine. Forward. See, which packet is this? First of all, a connection is built. Then your actual HTTP traffic will be sent. This thing is clear? Which flag is set? Act. Fine. Now your actual HTTP traffic will be sent. I will show you. See, information is up to which layer? Layer 7. And you will find here also. Which header is there? Earlier there was no HTTP header. But we are never concerned about HTTP header. Because this is not our work. Now we will send the information to the server. First of all, I will send my ACK packet. Then I will send my HTTP information to the server and server will reply me back. See here, inbound, this is my HTTP packet. I am getting reply also, HTTP. Fine, this thing is clear. So this is how things will work. I got a reply, I got my web page. Now if I again click on a small link, my computer has again generated a packet. You can see here, again it is trying to build up a connection. Again it will build up a connection, again it will get its reply. As you click on any link, computer will build up a connection, it will get a reply. Things will go on like this. Fine? Any issues?